Mr. Martin Ngatia, welcome back to this interview with the Kenya Red Alliance Media.
Thank you very much, Mr. Journalist.
Over the past week, we have seen that Deputy President William Ruto has been threatening human rights defender and photographer Boniface Mwangi over claims that Mwangi made to the effect that Ruto was involved in the assassination of Juma, the former anti-corruption crusader. What is your comment?
Thank you very much. First and foremost, I would like to congratulate Mr. Mwangi for his role he is playing in Kenya to liberate the oppressed people. He is their spokesman. I am not wrong when I say Mr. Mwangi, Boniface Mwangi, is a human rights defender and representing the Kenyan people. Mr. Mwangi should stay gumu. Ka gumu bwana. Chikilia hapo hapo. Ruto will take you nowhere. Do not fear those who kill body, but they cannot kill the soul. Mr. William Ruto is a criminal. He's a murderer. He's a rapist. He killed Kikuyu people in Eldoret 2007. He was indicted by the ICC. His case ended mystically. It was not clear because you cannot, in any case, like the International Criminal Court in Hague, you don't end cases simply because the accused has killed the witnesses, bribed and threatened. Believe me, these cases, when Kenya Red Alliance takes off, we shall, the first people to arrest will be Ruto, William Ruto. Arrest him, cage him, and put him to where he belongs. To prove criminal has no place in this modern time and era. William Ruto has killed so many Kenyans, that's how he rose up. He rise up from poverty. Remember, YK92, the former President Moi found Ruto and Jilogo, good lieutenants, to kill, to effect, and to occupy Kikuyu farms in Rift Valley. In fact, Boniface Mwangi was not the first person to mention who killed Juma. The first person to accuse Ruto was Jilogo, his friend in crime.
Wakati kijana mmoja ambaye alikuwa kwa wale ambao walikuwa wametumwa, alikuja akachapa mgale kwa gari yangu, George Captain alitoka mbio akapata huyo kijana, akamwangukia kwa miguu akashika. Sisi tulikuwa tunafikiri tumeshika mtu, lakini huyo kijana, rafiki yangu, ndio nikaelewa ana damu ya kuua. Alienda akageuza simu yake akaua huyo kijana. Kwani mlikuwa safari, unakumbuka yule aliua huyo kijana? Alikuwa Deputy President. Nini mnaelewa? Mtu akizoea kuwa watu, mtu akizoea kuwa watu ataendelea kuwa. Damu yake, damu ya wale ambao wamezikwa haitamwacha lale. Lazima atembee kila siku auwe. Juma.
He mentioned how Ruto killed Jacob Juma. Why didn't Ruto? The question to be asked, why didn't Ruto threaten his friend Jilogo to take him to court? But he threatened Mwangi. Mwangi was just quoting Mr. Jilogo. And this is a known fact. Ruto should know that he's a murderer, he's a rapist, he killed his bloods, his hands are smeared with the blood of Kikuyu children he burnt at Eldoret Church. He's a butcher of Eldoret, and his boss, Uhuru Kenyatta, is the butcher of Naivasha and Limuru, where they burnt children, they cut throat to poor mothers. Mr. William Ruto should not treat Kenyan people in this time and the era. He has been cheated by Kikuyus, and I have said again and again, Kikuyu never fought outside. Ruto will be used just like Saitoti. Perhaps he will end up Saitoti way. He will never be William Samoei Ruto. Will never be become a Kenya president. He has been cheated, he will succeed. Ruto, my friend, this country, history, go and read this country's history. You are nothing. You are just a thief. Even your people are opposing you. You, Ruto, you are a thief. Instead of fighting for Kenyan people, because you come from the poor family, you come from a peasant. Today you are rude, arrogant, thief. Unadanganya wa Kikuyu, naenda pale unaongea Kikuyu hapo kuambia, oh, mrega, mwana ni agochwa. Kitu gani? Utadanganya wajinga. We are very bitter, some of us. And the both of Kikuyu people are not, I am even telling you very clearly that come 22, you are nothing. You will never enter there. Take over after Uhuru. And challenge it. Probably you'll be nowhere to be seen. Believe me. Now, to threaten Mr. Mwangi, Boniface Mwangi, you'll do nothing. And if anything happens to Mwangi, you'll be held responsible. You know very clearly, we shall come for you, my friend. Who are you?
The level of intelligence of the people that they actually hire, they've actually formed these squads, hit squads, that are either controlled by Boynet, and the others controlled by Dogo Muhoho. And some of those hits could actually are also hired by politicians.
Let me finish. You don't even know the name of the director of CID.
Nego Muhoro. It's Muhoro. Nego Muhoro.
You look very ignorant.
Who runs this hit? Let me finish this actually.
Yeah.
Jacob Juma was killed by police hit squad. George Moshai was killed by police hit squad. Some of these big murders in this country, or a land dealer at Ekuno Skill, is done by actually the police hit squad.
But those are not allegations that can be proven.
No, if they think it's not true, they can take me to court. He's here, he can investigate me. My point is very well, this is actually the people of the capacity to do some of these killings are police officers.
A thief should not be respected. A criminal like you should not be respected at all. Or you should not be left to go scot-free. We are waiting for you. The whole world is watching you. And believe me, as I have said before, and in my videos, we are not Jesus Christ to forgive criminals like you, their sins. I think this country, the people of Kenya, has been forgiving criminals since this country got fake independence from Britain. Because when Jomo Kenyatta killed Pio Pinto, nothing happened. He killed Tom Mboya, nothing happened. J.M. Kariuki, nothing happened. Kung'o Karoba, etc. Tell him he took over, murdered the Kenyan people. He killed Otuka and the others, detained the others. Believe me, Mr. Ruto, I can assure you, if Kenyan people forget, the leadership of KRE does not forget or even forgive. We are coming for you. You are just rubbish and did nothing. You are cheating Kenyan people. We are not these people you cheat. Our fathers fought for that country. People fought for this country. Even to this day, the struggle continues. Aruto goes, Aruto continues. So stop threatening Mwangi. And Mwangi, sleep comfortable at Umorote. Hakuna pahali atakupeleka. Yeye, Ghasia. a murderer, a rapist, a useless man who treated the people in this time and era. He is nothing. He is rubbish. He is being used. He was bought. He is being used. I repeat again. Ruto, William Ruto is being used. Utatumiwa kama wale walikuwa bele yako na hakuna pahali utapeleka watu. Takuwa takataka, believe me. We don't want criminal. You are just nothing. At nothing. Thank you.